Hey guys, I want to talk to you about mat maintenance. If you're brand new to your practice, you probably picked up your yoga mat at Target or Walmart or something like that, probably paid somewhere between $8 to $12 for it. And while it's a great place to start, it's better than nothing, those types of mats are absorbent, which makes it nice right off the bat because if you have sweaty hands, you put them on the mat, you're going to stick a little bit better. But in the long run, those are absorbing sweat and that can't be washed off. It's being absorbed into the actual material of the mat. So it sits there and it grows bacteria and it, you know, they'll start to stink and then they'll disintegrate too. I don't know if you've been in a studio class where, especially gym classes, where people tend to have the inexpensive mats. And after class, you look around and there's shreds of pieces of, you know, multicolored yoga mat confetti all over the place because they're just not meant to last. And they fall apart, but they're not biodegradable. So they end up, you know, in the ocean, in the landfills. So what I suggest and what I've done in my studio, my practice, my own life is I only use Manduka Pro yoga mats. And so there's a lot of reasons for that. One is that it's a lifetime yoga mat. It's not biodegradable. So I mean, that is something to consider, but it's one and done. You buy one Manduka Pro mat and you're gonna have it for the rest of your life. Also, the density of the material, the actual cushion that you get is so far superior to any of the other yoga mats that I've ever tried, and I've tried a lot. Now the other reason is because the surface is non-porous. The surface is non-absorbent. So when you sweat on a Manduka mat, it's gonna wash off. Nothing is gonna soak into it. So for the life of your mat, for every single practice, you can start with an absolutely clean, fresh surface, right? So with that said, I've talked to a lot of my students and it turns out they don't necessarily clean their mats that often. And I suggest cleaning your mat every single practice. Now, I clean my mat every time right after practice. I use my solution, I spray it, I use a wet cloth, I scrub it down, I let it dry, then I roll it up. Then when I roll it out for practice, usually I'll take a wet rag, spray some of my cleaner, and then just give it another once over to get any dust off, to get any, you know, whatever off the surface. And then it also makes it just feel so fresh when you're going into your child's poses and things like that, where you have your face close to the mat and what you smell is fresh peppermint and lavender, you know, instead of dust and feet. You know, which is what a lot of mats smell like. So anyway, especially if you have a Manduka, I highly recommend that you scrub it after every use. You'll just get used to it. It's not hard. It only takes a minute and it improves the surface of your mat over time. It just gets better and better and better. So to make the yoga cleaner, the yoga mat cleaner that I use, I start with, this says 28 ounces on it here. I think it's probably 32 ounces up to here. I fill it clear to the top. So that's what I use. Then I add pure Castile soap. I use Dr. Bronner's. You can use whatever kind you want. I get the peppermint or the lavender kind, just so it already has some lavender essential oil in it, because I'm gonna add some typically anyway. But there's a lot of different varieties available. There's like a citrus and orange. I think there's even a rose. There's quite a few different options, and you don't have to use Dr. Bronner. You can use, you know, any Castile soap that you want to. And so in this bottle, I start with it empty. I'll add about a tablespoon of the Dr. Bronner's or the pure Castile soap. To that, I'll add about 5 drops of tea tree oil. Now, tea tree oil doesn't smell great, but tea tree oil is an antifungal. So with the tea tree oil in your mix, it's just a good idea for a yoga mat where you're gonna have feet all over it all the time, it's a good idea to have a little bit of antifungal protection in there. So that's what the tea tree oil is for. It doesn't necessarily smell good. Then I like to add about 5 drops of peppermint and about 10 drops of lavender. That recipe for me is just perfect because it smells fresh, clean. It's a pleasure when you spray it and start scrubbing because it just smells fantastic. It does a really good job of cleaning your mat, and it's all natural products. It's all good for your body. All right, so hopefully you'll give this mat cleaner a try and adopt the habit of scrubbing your mat after every practice. Thanks. Have a great day. Bye.